Welcome to Office 2013, video number 23. Hey, if you want to download this workbook, and this workbook's for video 23 to 27, click on the link below the video or go to our class website. Hey, we're still studying Excel. This is Excel Basics number 5. We just want to take a little bit of time and talk about customizing the ribbon and the quat. Quick Access Toolbar. Let's start with the Quick Access Toolbar. So up here, if I want to move it down below, especially if I'm going to customize it, because then I can have lots of room to add buttons, I simply right-click the Quick Access Toolbar and say, Show Quick Access Toolbar Below. And now our quat is below, and we have lots of real estate to add buttons. Now, there's two reasons you want to add buttons to your Quick Access Toolbar. If you always work on the Data tab, and you do things like increase, decrease, decimals, or conditional formatting. Notice, if I'm always working here, I have to go back over to the Home to get these buttons. But notice that the quat, as I click through the ribbon tabs, is always showing. Oh, that is so cool. So one way to add buttons is simply go to whatever command you see in the ribbons and right-click Add to Quick Access Toolbar. Boom. Right-click Add. Right-click Add. Look at that. Amazing. Now, if I'm working on the Data tab, I'm working, those buttons are always showing. The other reason you want to add buttons to the Quick Access Toolbar is there's some commands that are not in the ribbons. So we can right-click the Quick Access Toolbar and say, Customize Quick Access Toolbar. It instantly brings us to Excel Options, Quick Access Toolbar, and the trick is choose commands from. If you want to look at every command that's available in Excel, go to All Commands. And I love this because I just then go through the list and add my buttons. Click Add and add them over here. If you want to see the ones that are just not in the ribbon, commands not in ribbon. Now I'm going to add just one button here. I'm going to type the letter S to jump to the S's because I know down here somewhere is Speak Cells on Enter. Once I've selected the button, I click Add. Again, the idea is you use commands not in ribbon or all commands and simply go through and add, and add as many as you'd like. Now, you can also remove some. Save, I use Control S. I'm never going to use that button. Undo, never going to use it. I use Control Z. Redo, I use Control Y. You can not only build by adding and removing, but you can also reorder them. So decrease decimal is the one I use the most, so I'm going to put it at the top here, which means it would be the leftmost on the Quick Access Toolbar. And next video in keyboards, we'll see how to access quickly all of these quat elements using our keyboards. There's also the reset button. That's important. Sometimes you need to reset it back to the default. Click OK. And instantly I have customized my quat. And there's lots of real estate, so you can add as many buttons as you want. Now ribbons. The ribbons, there's the home ribbon. These are the most common tasks that people use. They tried to pile them all into the home. Insert ribbon, we've already seen a pivot table. There's pictures. Page layout, we've already done a bunch of page layout. There's formula stuff, so it's kind of organized in a logical way. Data, like sorting, filtering. Now, customizing. Customizing came in 2010, so if you have 2010 or 13, you can customize the ribbons. Now notice there's some real estate over here. So you can actually create a new group and a new button. So the one we're going to do is we learned last video that Insert Pivot Table is on the Insert menu in the Tables group, which I guess sort of makes sense. But if you've been using Excel a long time or you do data analysis, well, wait a second. Pivot Table is like the most amazing data analysis feature, and it's not in this ribbon. So let's see if we can customize it and add it. Right-click and customize the ribbon. One thing you might also want to do is the developer ribbon is not showing by default, so you can simply uncheck it. But notice you can check and uncheck whichever ribbon tab you'd like. Let's go to data. And you click on the data ribbon, say new group. Notice there's a new tab. You can add a whole new tab, just your own customized tab. I'm going to say new group, It's highlighted. I'm going to click rename. Oh, look at that, a bunch of cool symbols. I'm going to call this pivot table. Click OK. So now I have that. And now I go over to whichever one, all commands, and then you can pile in whatever you want. I'm going to type P and jump to the P area and click the pivot table and add. Wow, just like that. Click OK. And just like that, is that totally amazing? Oh. So, customizing the ribbons, customizing the quat, making your job easier because the commands are where you want them. All right, we'll see you next video.